going to walk through how chargebacks, also known as disputes, work between the Stripe and NetSuite integration. A chargeback is initiated by the customer on a card that they already had a payment on through your site. So Stripe would, you know, run a charge on their card, and then the customer, sometime later after the charge occurs, is going to go to their bank or their credit card and say, hey, that was a fraudulent transaction, or that company did not deliver me the service or goods that I purchased. And then what the credit card company is going to do is pull the cash directly from you, the merchant, through Stripe, and hold it in their account until they determine who wins the chargeback or who wins the dispute. So from a kind of transaction flow standpoint in Stripe, what happens here is when a chargeback is initiated by the customer, the cash for the original payment is immediately removed from your balance. So it's essentially a forced refund, and Stripe charges you a $15 fee. So what happens later on in the cycle is you go ahead and you reply to the chargeback and you indicate, hey, I actually shipped the goods to the customer, or I did deliver that online service. And then it's up to the credit card company to decide who wins. If you win, the credit card company sends the cash back to your Stripe account, which then gets deposited in your bank, and you get the processing fee refunded. So that's kind of the whole dispute workflow. There's two parts of that where NetSuite's involved in recording the initial dispute, which is essentially a forced refund, and then if you win, recording the cash coming back into your account. So what I'm gonna do is walk through an example flow here. It's a little contrived because normally a dispute happens, you know, days or weeks after the charge occurs. But in this case, it happened, you know, immediately after I submitted the payment in Stripe. So I'm going to walk through the whole transaction flow from the chargeback being initiated to you winning the chargeback. So to start things off, I have an invoice here. This is just a successful payment on an invoice, kind of representing that initial order that you would make through a company. And we have a payment here that's created by SuiteSync. So we're going to open up this payment in Stripe. So in Stripe, you can see that the payment's disputed. Stripe will indicate that a payment is disputed on the payment itself, but they also have a disputes tab where you can walk through a list of all your disputed transactions. At this point, there's not a resolution on the dispute. It's still kind of in progress. But immediately when we receive a notification from Stripe that a payment has been disputed, we're going to create a credit memo and a customer refund to represent that dispute. If it was just a cash payment that was unapplied, essentially just an unapplied customer deposit or an unapplied customer payment, we won't create a credit memo and we'll just create a customer refund against that cash transaction. So in most cases, a dispute is going to occur after the payment's been deployed against an invoice. So in most cases, you will have both a credit memo and a customer refund. So let's take a look at those. So this credit memo here looks really similar to a credit memo for a refund, if you're familiar with those. The big difference here is there's a Stripe ID which starts with DP underscore. So this DP underscore indicates that this is a dispute generated credit memo. In this case, we chose to use the original items on the invoice for the dispute credit memo, but it's possible to use a different item completely so the GL impact changes or is different than the original invoice. So for instance, we could use a Stripe dispute item that could post to a unique GL account so that that contra income entry for the dispute goes to a completely separate account. So this credit memo handles the kind of reversal of the income that was associated with the original payment. The next part is the reversal of the cash. So for that, you can see that this credit memo is applied to a customer refund. We hop over to that customer refund here. We can see that it posts to your undeposited funds account and also has that dispute ID. So similar to a refund, the dispute is going to, it takes a couple days to kind of reverse out of your available balance. And so in one or two business days, this customer refund, which represents the dispute, is going to be included in a bank deposit. The other piece to this process is Stripe charges you a $15 dispute processing fee. So if we hop over to an example deposit and look at the cashback column, you can see there's an adjustment fees line item with a $15 fee. This just represents that dispute fee that Stripe charges you, and you can post it to a unique expense account. So let's say you go ahead and you fight the dispute and you win. In that case, you're gonna get this fee refunded and the cash is gonna be returned to your account. So let's take a look at what that looks like. So here is another deposit which represents the cash coming back to your account. Here you can see the $15 fee deposited in your account and the chargeback reversal. So essentially the full amount of that original payment being returned to an income account that you choose. Since the invoice has already been paid and then refunded, it's not possible to associate the funds coming back into your account to that original invoice. You have to pick another income account to push that dispute to. So that's a quick walkthrough of how disputes work. It's worth noting that you should take a look at our fraud prevention documentation and video that walks through how to use Stripe's fraud system to prevent an order from being fulfilled or change your fulfillment workflow depending on your fraud rules. But this is kind of all the details as far as how we handle chargebacks and disputes in your NetSuite account.